challenging. And the challenge is being that the funding space has really changed and has really shifted. We no longer have the resources that we used to enjoy that the communities would be able to access. But then also this offers an opportunity for funders like us, whose approach is actually a participatory one, who believe in communities being able to lead the process of eradicating any pandemic, and in this particular case in HIV. So it gives me a lot of hope and just to have a positive mindset to believe that the communities, as we have building communities, their resilience is shown on how they continue existing despite the cuts that have been ongoing, despite the negative rhetorics around people living with HIV, despite the negative rhetorics around people who are considered key population, LGBTIQ and sex workers. So the resilience of the movement is actually what gives me hope.